Welcome to New Hampshire for race number 18. Is it 18? No. Well, Sam Curtis and John Gilbert are on the front row. Here's the full final results.
Start your engines!
Engine fired up. That's it for the green. My throat feels something. Like shit, I guess. Try to keep talking. Yeah, okay, race number 18. So Ash Curtis, turns out he was not having a bad season. Oh, fuck. Shit. No, not that. Damn device won't turn off. Okay, it's off now. He's a 70 point... No, he's behind 72 points. Behind Henry Williams. Sean Ryan looks like he's got problems. Where is the 5? 5 is over there. The 07. Probably off course. Looks like it's further back. All the way at the back. Have to do a lot of passing today. Want to get that 5 car. Pace car is in. Here we go. Getting ready for the green. Green flag is out. Here we go. We're underway. It looks like the old one trying to slide up already. And John Gilbert. Oh, trouble. Almost. Oh, trouble with the 16. And I thought he just had a good restart. Not restart. Good start. And he's holding everyone back. And oh, here we go. And the 5 car gets collected. Yeah. So the caution's out already. And looks like Fisher in the 9 car is your race leader. That was unexpected. This caution is out for the first time. The number 9 in front. Well, take a look at the replay. I thought Gilbert had a good start. He did have a good start. And I thought he was going to block the 55. Here he goes. Of course, there is no penalty for passing him. Look at that. Look at the... gap he got, because he's on the outside, and he completely passed the whole car. He was clear, more than clear, but then he cuts down. I thought he was blocking him from this angle, you know. I thought he just, you know, he wasn't clear, but he was actually was. And then he just starts slowing down. But everyone just stacks up. 5. He's on the flat. Of course, yeah, there's that little flat spot. And he gets into the wall. You have a second wreck, by the way. So big championship implications, I think. That's the word. 38 also around in the grass. Not too much damage there. We'll take a look at this one more time. Right on board with the 55. I thought we were going to get some realistic stuff going on. Oh wait, of course, you can't get a penalty for that. So he cuts down, looks like, you know, he was just doing a normal block. And then, turns out he was actually really slow. Fisher takes advantage, he takes the lead. Of course, we got ourselves a second wreck, and we'll fast forward. Coming off turn 3, didn't start from here. Started from somewhere. So Gilbert goes down pit road, oh, there it is. Of course, these guys are all, you know, trying to avoid Gilbert. They'll try to avoid the wreck. So they're all over the place. And 5 wide for a brief second. Kalman gets into him. The Brian Fox, DJ Curtis gets collected. It seemed okay. And Noni Green and the 29 Watkins, Glenn Winter. Ash Curtis has to stop, and here comes everyone else. Now he gets launched in the air by Aiden Shepherd, and DJ Curtis goes upside down. Of course, we got a lot more. It just keeps stacking up. Look at that. Arca brakes. They just keep piling, and look at Aureus into the catch fence. He almost goes upside down. Wow. So, the top 2 in points. Yep, Ash Curtis. So he's got to finish ahead of the 5 at least. At least be ahead of the 5. Make things More easier. It's better than nothing. Wow. What a wreck. Two wrecks. Two big wrecks. Well, actually, no. One big wreck. Two wrecks under one caution on the first lap. Usually just big wreck coming off four. Okay, we'll take you back to the restart. Lights are out, getting ready for the green. 26 cars remaining, and well, Ash Curtis 28th, Henry Williams 38th. 10 positions, 10 spots right there. That's a lot. Kind of. 26 cars ring on the racetrack as green flag waves. Fisher to a good restart. Does Sam Curtis have car problems now? Tough season for both of them. Two big names and whoa, contact! Joshua Hyatt just knocked Kyle out of the way. A little robbery. Rivalry going on right there, maybe. Brennan Brock in one car. He'll take third away. Yeah, we don't have a lot of cars left after that big one. They just kept stacking up. Yeah, about these two there. Now these two, I know for sure they're not having good seasons. Sam Curtis in the 55, right at the beginning of the season. First race, already under fire, yeah, from Tony Green, who has yet to actually pay him back. I think they part of, you know, they settle their ways. Is that right? I don't know, but here comes Curtis in the 55. He'll take the lead, but can he clear him? Neck and neck, two Dodges. And 9 all the way to the top. Curtis takes the lead, new leader. Oh, he did start on the pole, never led a lap. He'll lead this one, though. Gilbert, you know, he's 26th. He's still running, but even with no damage, he is slow, so... They fixed it, but he, of course, got, you know, Brian Fox, he's got some damage. You know, Calvin has damage as well, but he's maintaining his spot. So definitely a mechanical failure, but they got it fixed, though. They got it fixed. Jake Jefferson on the 41, even with the win at Talladega, he's still, you know, very deep in the points. He might, you know, gain a few spots in the point off. Well, you'll maybe question. Yeah, really nothing to lose if you're all the way at the back, all the way deep in the standings this late in the season. He's currently the lowest running driver, ranking driver out of ever with a victory. 39th at that one win at Talladega. You're not interested in Aline. He's somewhere around there. Oh, that's not good. He puts him out there. He didn't hit the wall. Wow, how did Matt Dealey save that from getting him to the wall? It's a rookie versus a veteran right there. Lots of Dodges. There's Sebastian Torres. He's the lowest running driver with multiple wins. Yeah, we all thought he was going to be a championship contender with two early wins, but looks like... Oh, the 09 and the 41! Oh, he almost took out Torres, too. 09's on it right here. He'll have to keep his streak alive, maybe. Well, he's only 6 spots away from 10th. But, yeah. So, yeah, Torres, we all thought he was a championship contender, but, yeah, the bad halfway point curse got him. Of course, we have not mentioned that because of the chase we had, but this has no chase. So, it's all about consistency and points and all that good stuff. Even with 2 wins. No chance at the championship. Unrealistic. Pretty much. With only 3 races left, including this one. 2 when this one's complete. Back to the front, I think it's 55. Well, William Brock has taken second. Fisher falls to third. There's the 11. Not a good season for the 11 car either. Battle for fifth. Blaine Keyes. Whoa, contact! Oh, Kyle, look at that. He got into the 14. Little payback there. He scraped the wall, maintains his spot though. Well, the 18 looks like he was the biggest loser right there, because he's now battling the 24, losing a couple spots, but he's able to clear him off of 4. We'll same crews just trying to get one out here. A lot of drivers are doing the same with the season closing to an end, coming to an end, closing to an end. What the hell? All you can pretty much do is just go for it. You know, don't never mind about points or anything like that. I just passed the halfway point, just noticed, and well, looks like Gilbert got by the 40. That's a 32. I think he still has a shot at the championship. A lot of unexpected drivers. Ash Curtis, the 32. I didn't know they're all championship contenders, and they are. And with the 5 out in the 07 and all those people, Josh Dale in the 10. He's also still out there. Yes, there he is. He was 2nd. He's currently 9th. 2nd in points. Lost it though. He's lost 4 spots after the Glen. But I think he's still got a chance. Still got a shot at this. Battling 2 other drivers, trying to maintain 9th. 9th would be good, and pick slides up. Your pick. We did see him in the top 5 a few times. Boston was probably his best run until he got taken out. Got onto the grass twice. He spun out in the first. Got back up. Kept going. We're looking for a top 5. And look at Jake West. The pick just came into the bottom there. He kind of... Oh, Matt Dalio gets into him. Pick slides up. Almost. Almost. Pick has won races before. He hasn't raced that much. It's been a while since he was racing in this league, but not doing so well for his comeback. He's doing okay now, though. He goes a 14 going by the 9 car. Look at the gap. 55's got a big lead with William Brock half a second back. 10 laps to go, by the way. Sam Curtis trying to just cruise to victory. Maybe you could say. There's William Brock trying to close in and get him. I think everyone in the top 10 needs to win. I don't think any of these guys have won. So from 1st to 11th, I believe. Torres won. Dalio, no. Jamie, yes. Henny, yes. Tristan, no. Jay, yes. 26, no. 20, 12, no. 42, yes. And yeah, there's the rest. Here comes William Brock, closing in fast. 0.3. He's cutting off a 10th of a second. 10th? No, a 10th. 0.1. Let's just say decimal numbers for now. Closing in on William Brock is closing in on Sam Curtis. Right there now. Closing in on the 40 car too. But with these guys all separate, it's okay. Now the 11's open for these two to go side by side. Get a 3 car battle for the race win. But if they catch Brian Fox, will he be a factor? Maybe. Last time Sam was able to pull away just a little bit. Just a very little. Here he goes. He kind of overdrives it though. He was there. I guess you got 2 slow cars. Next up is the 16, so 2 drivers. If they catch, gonna be 5 to go. Maybe William Brock setting them up, trying to leave some space so he doesn't get held up. 5 to go. If the caution doesn't come out, we'll catch that 40. Now these guys might cause a wreck. I kept it clean for a bit. Mike are slowly losing positions. He was the leader at the restart. And just slowly kept losing it. Look at this, 3 wide. Keep it clean. I don't want another race ending under yellow, but that might not happen as Pick knocks him into the wall. He scraped it. Fighting hard for a position right here. Here goes the 1. He looks not close enough to make a move. As they're closing in on the 40 car. Coming to 3 to go. William Brock on the lower line. Sam Curtis on the outside. 3 laps to go. Closing in on the 40.
Don't think we'll catch a 16, though. Catch a 40, maybe. Almost likely. There goes William Rock again. Classic two bar. No. Seriously? And that was the 9 and the 26. Caution! I really wish I could modify this game to take green-white checkers. You got to be kidding. You know, this might not happen if Papyrus still had the license to make NASCAR games. Maybe. But we were so close that we really needed that caution. Did we really need that caution? I had a feeling they were gonna wreck. Had a fucking feeling. They just had the wreck. They just had to. It takes like our fifth race ending under yellow. So that's three races in a row. Michigan, the Glen, and now New Hampshire. And we're having a good race too. How do you change the sensitivity of cautions? Because I know it's possible. I know it's possible. Well, the white is out. Sam Curtis is going to win this race. Well, Curtis was lucky that he didn't have to catch Brian Fox. Well, he did catch him, but caution came out. For a second, I thought it was Seamlings. But no, the caution was actually out. Checkers in yellow. Checkers and yellow. Sam Curtis in the 55 takes it at New Hampshire. Now we'll take a look at the full race results, and we'll take a look at the wreck. So only two cautions, and the second one has come at the most worst timing ever. They kept it clean for so long, and then they wreck at the end. So Sam Curtis takes it, William Brock. Actually, I don't want to say it. I'm already out of breath. So, here's your full call of race results, and we'll take a look at the wreck. I don't believe it. I just don't believe it. There it is. 9 and 7, 26 teammates. Yeah, teammates! 10, 19, and 9. What? Was Dalio trying to wreck his own teammates so he can gain more points and all that stuff? So he can, like... Oh, he finished 11th. He was 13th. Yes, that 10 car is part of the Everham. If you didn't know, 2006 roster. And Jeff got into it. Lots of damage. He was 3 wide, but they kept it clean. And yeah, Dalio just knocked two of his teammates. He just gets in the Taurus. Taurus gets in the Fisher. And just flat out... Well, it looks like they're going to keep it clean. The 9 bounces off the wall. He doesn't slowly inch his way to the wall. He hit it enough. Bounces right off. And that's pretty much it. So the race is complete. Sam Curtis... And just when William Brock closes in, we could have had a good race, a good finish. But no. No. Well, I'll take you to victory lane.